Good morning. Welcome to the FTS Betslip on Friday, February the 26th. This is pod number, anybody know, 765. Of course it is. Samba time in Brazil last night. See, it's worth listening. It's worth listening. It's worth staying up late. All the little shit I talk, but you get the little gems. Sporting Recife, get in there. Well done to those of you who did stay up and cash in. A lot of goals in Brazil last night as the season ended and J-League has started today. So one finishes, one starts. Some concerns that the singing's going to stop. Of course it's not. Just think next week. Next week when I finally break this cycle after Tuesday, I'm going to have the Wednesday, Thursday, no pod. I'll be like a coiled spring come Friday morning. The first hour will be like a concert. I'll be churning out all the tunes. I've had to bin the now that's what I call music experiment. I don't know what number I got up to. I got into the 30s. Wasn't the late 90s music a load of old shit, honestly. Like through the 80s, fantastic. Early 90s, not bad. And then just this boom, 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 bollocks. Honestly, I had to stop. Sam came in, I was listening to some Billy Joel. She said, what's happened to the now? I said, I've had to bin it. I said, I can't cope with it anymore. And people said, I've been sounding stressed this week. No, I'm not. I genuinely am not stressed at all. I am absolutely loving life. Obviously, you know, it's difficult, isn't it, for everybody? And Sam's had some issues, as I've sort of said. But no, I'm absolutely fine. The podcast ending isn't, or no, it's not ending. I'm just cutting a few days off. It's nothing to do with stress or this. It's just making decisions on freeing a bit of time up, thinking forward, as I said, you should all do. But if I did sound stressed, I certainly am not. You'll know when I'm stressed because you'll get one. Don't forget the breakfast as well. I only had a few. I thought people would be charging the post the FTS breakfast. It's going to be worth a few quid, I would think. Yeah, get it on. Hashtag FTS breakfast. Too many people always don't eat that shit. Well, make an exception. Don't eat it. Just throw it in the bin. Take it to the homeless. Do something with it. Make an FTS breakfast. Win some money and go do something else with it. Give it to an old person. What else was I going to say? There was something. Oh, here's one. You know you can't sneeze without closing your eyes. It's impossible. So you can't sneeze. Your eyes will shut. Fact. Got another one. My boys told me this one, and I think it's actually true. And again, it'll be down to eating unhealthy food, but there'll be people who do it. A jam donut. So you've got not a ring donut, one, you know, the old stuffed one with jam. Jam piped in the middle. It's impossible to eat a jam donut without licking your lips. Try it. It's impossible. I had to go round the shop and get a donut to try this because somebody told me it. My boy told me it. So he told me it. He said it's impossible. And I went, and it is impossible. Couldn't do it. So there you go. If you can do it, I want video evidence. I don't just want, oh, I did it. Smart asses. So there you go. The stuff you learn here, you just don't get it anywhere else. There, you're learning about how to eat jam donuts. It's amazing. I don't know why I don't get any votes in these awards and things for podcasts. I don't get anything. Just sit here talking to myself. Right, what we got this week? Let's do the EPL preview. I think these have been going quite well. I don't know whether people are paying any attention to them again or I talk to myself, but I told you last week the bet of the week's out West Ham and over 2.5. I told you it. Got a good one this week that I like. Some boots filling time to be had. Right, we have got Man City versus West Ham to kick things off. The battle of the top two teams in 2021. Older Man United fans going, they're not top two teams, we're second. I said 2021. Without doubt, the top two teams of 2021 are Man City and West Ham, both relentlessly marching on. City seem to be marching to everything, don't they? Not just the Premier League title, everything else. They've got the Carabao Cup in the bag for sure. We could go just straight to the trophy ceremony for that, couldn't we? Just save the embarrassment of our lot. Just go straight out there. West Ham last week, I said they'd beat Spurs. I was very confident they'd beat Spurs. And the 2.5 Spurs, shit. So, but I'm not sure that West Ham will have that success here. It's difficult to see past a City win. There's nothing in it price-wise for me. I thought unders may offer a bit of value, but when you dig into City's record with Pep in this odds bracket against top four teams, it's still relentless. Relentless, just goal after goal. So it's just one to watch for me, but I do think we'll see a City win, but I'm not going to get involved at 1.26. It's another one, I've said it a few times this season, you could lay City at 1.26. It's really low risk, and perhaps trade a few ticks, because West Ham are quite stubborn. They'll be tough. It's just one of those things, if City score early, then it's game over. They scored in 2 minutes against Arsenal last week, didn't they, and it only ended 1-0, but different proposition at home, I think. Irrespective of fans or no fans, I think you're just going to watch City march on. Not West Ham, I've got them on the brain. See, they're haunting me, they're in my head. 9 points clear, and they're better than us, that's a fact. I've told Suggsy, West Ham will finish above Spurs for the next couple of years. Whatever anybody says about him, I think he's a good manager, Moyes. He's done it with Everton, he's going to do it with this mob, which just is soul-destroying. It won't be a fluke. People will say, COVID this season, Liverpool have underperformed, Chelsea, made an error appointing Frank, Tottenham are shit, Arsenal are shit, Wolves have been bad. But I am confident that I'll stick my neck out and say David Moyes will establish West Ham as a top 6-7 club for the next few seasons. So there you go. That's how depressed I am. There. That's why I'm stressed. When I say I'm stressed, that's what stresses me. Them up there. No, I'm only joking. West Brom v Brighton. Right. Many raving about Brighton and Potter. Playing great football, not taking chances. Look at their XG numbers. My views on XG are well known. Call me old fashioned. I like to focus on what has happened as opposed to what might have happened if my auntie had balls and all that. There are times, as I've said, particularly with goalkeepers, when I like it, but the reality is Brighton have won 5 games of football. That is the reality. That's the absolute facts of it. This is one they could win because Rubber Ball are absolutely awful. But they do come off 2 home draws against Fulham and United. I just can't have Brighton at 202. I cannot have them. In this, they are bottom six in this visitation to the Premier League, because it will be a visitation. They won't be here forevermore. They've been away. They've been in the bottom six and played a bottom six team away from home 7 times. They've only won 1 of them, and that was against Norwich last year. Rubber Ball up and down since 2015, and in that period they've played 10 home games against bottom six sides and only lost 4 of them. Slightly distorted that, because one of those was Chelsea when they started the season badly in 15-16, and another one was Southampton at the start of the season when they were both bottom six by the alphabet. So people can wax on about Brighton all they like, they can wax on about Potter all they like. West Brom may not win any games, because they are poor. They're going to go down, but he's going to make them harder to beat as this season goes on. They're not going to be letting 4 or 5 in all the time. And I just can't have Brighton at 202. Just like, for me, it's a lay of Brighton. I just can't have them at that price. It's irrespective of what you think. I just think it's a ridiculous price, 202 Brighton. I do. I just think it's mad. They're a bottom six side that have won 5 games. That's it. Plain and simple, you can wax on about what they might well have done or should have done or this, that and the other. They're not that good. Leeds v Villa. Leeds win one, lose one, win one, lose one. Tom Hill, he I think he put it on Twitter and he's telegramming me saying thanks for the pod, and will I be putting aside one of my pods in May to apologise to Bielsa for my comments? Good luck with that, Tom. I will do a fair appraisal end of season when 38 games have played. Leeds are fun to watch, for sure. I just think the waxing on about Bielsa ball is far too much for me. But we'll see where they end up. Well, they're only a point behind us, but we're shit, see? So if we're shit and you're a point behind us, what are you? But few teams rely on one player. Very few teams. Tottenham are become a bit of a Harry Kane team at times, but Villa are one. Villa whilst they have improved, Grealish is just a massive player for them. Last Friday's preview would have been different had I tapped into the fantasy football knowledge and known he was not playing last week. He's a fantastic player. I think he's just a great player. I think he's one of England's shining lights. We'll manage to fuck him up somewhere, I expect, with Southgate in charge. But he does carry this team. I don't care what anybody says. He's brilliant. And I think not having him, I don't believe he's playing, in case they'll lose it. So not a big bet game for me, but Leeds at 2.3. If Grealish doesn't play, I'd expect Leeds to go and win this game. Sorry, Villa fans, I know I've got a few listeners. You'll all be, what the fuck you know. Newcastle versus Wolves. Geordie's rather just panic mode, aren't they? They've got to be. I mean, I'll go on about being a Spurs fan, but being a Geordie fan over the last 20 years must have just been murder. They're just one of the strangest clubs you come across. Always seem to be fighting some sort of turmoil, shooting themselves in the foot with managerial appointments, whatever it may be, you know. They had a great manager in Benitez, whatever people's views on him, and absolutely daft to not move heaven and earth to keep him. Wolves seem to have found their spark again last couple of games. You know, did have a real wobble over the Christmas period. Fair play, they stuck with the manager. No bet, and it may be a dogged affair, but given the state of the two clubs at the minute, I would side with Wolves and perhaps lay Newcastle. Newcastle are banging trouble now, and it's difficult to see where they're going to get wins. It really is. Just banging trouble. You know, a lot it's going to be. I think Burnley, I said Dyche will have enough. You know, Burnley have only lost one in their last five. And I don't expect them to lose this weekend. I think we'll get to that in a minute. But you know, Fulham. If Fulham can turn some form around, Fulham, Newcastle, Brighton, they're all right in it. It's one of those three to go down with the other one, and I wouldn't like to pick one at the minute. I genuinely wouldn't like to say which one it's going to be. Start of the season, I said it's Fulham, but I think, you know, they've had two of their last three. They've got every opportunity to try and win another one this weekend. Be interesting. And that brings me on. Palace v Fulham is next. Palace, the smash and grab against Brighton. I mean, they will have absolutely loved that. You'd have seen Palace fans leaping around their front room. And at the prices here, it's 3.65 Palace, 3.3 the draw, 2.32 Fulham. At the prices, I wouldn't want to touch any outcome. I just want bigger prices if I was going to have a bet. So I couldn't tell you who's going to win. I think Fulham could go there and win. Palace perfectly capable of winning. That goal will have done Benteke the world of good. So, yeah, just one I'm steering right clear of. I genuinely haven't even got an opinion. If somebody held a gun to me, I'd still say I don't know. So just one I'm leaving alone altogether. Leicester versus Arsenal, 2.64 Leicester, 3.45 the draw, 2.96 Leicester. I think a bit of a surprise defeat last night. I didn't see the team news. I didn't watch the game, so I'm not... any idea of the rest lineup? I think I saw somewhere on Twitter that Madison didn't play, but I might have made that up. I don't know. I just think Leicester, if they're going to compete in Europe, I think they need a bigger squad. You know, their first 11 is, I think, is really good. Tielemans, Madison, Vardy, etc. Solid, talented group. But I think if they want to take that into Europe, playing Thursday, Sunday, or, you know, next year it will be Tuesday, Wednesday, Sunday, or Tuesday, Wednesday, Saturday with Champions League, then they need to obviously expand that squad and have a bit more quality right through it. So they, if they do rest players, they can bring decent players in. In the Premier League, different kettle of fish, solid, talented group in 20 Premier League teams against... home against as a top six team against middle third. They've won 14 of them. I mean, that equates to odds of 1.43. You know, the 2.64. It looks nice. Conversely, Arsenal, who, you know, they're a mid-table side. You know, can't say they aren't because they are. And as a mid-table side, they've only won one away to a top six side, and that was Wolves last year. They've lost to Chelsea, Spurs, etc. I like Leicester's pricing, and I think Leicester will win. I think they'll shirk that disappointment last night off. They've now only got the league to focus on, in essence. Now they're out of Europe. That'll be their main focus, getting that top four spot. Arsenal had a tough game themselves against Benfica. Of course, me tipping Leicester now, my record would probably kickstart Arsenal's season. But I do like Leicester here, and I like the price, 2.64. I also like dripping over 2.5 through first 10 minutes here and trading on the goals. So Leicester as a bet and trade the over 2.5. Tottenham versus Burnley, 1.6 Tottenham, 4.2 the draw, 7.2 Burnley. You got to laugh. This game last season, Spurs went off 1.42. The first half goal Poisson pre-match number was 1.38. The over 2.5 was 1.89 as Spurs racked up a 5-0 win. This year, Spurs are 1.6. The Poisson first half goal number is 1.68. The over 2.5 is 3.51. And it definitely won't be a 5-0 win, that I can guarantee. Mourinho will probably start one of Bale and Ali. Probably Bale, I would think. And that may help. But the rancid football and string of defeats won't be changing in a flash, Spurs fans. This is exactly the sort of game Spurs will struggle in. Burnley will set up behind the ball. Spurs will be clueless. You know, they just lack creativity in that. You know, even if Bale plays, they just lack that creativity, and then they just remain porous at the back to set pieces, etc. I just couldn't back Spurs at 1.6. You know, Peter, say, oh, you're down. Since the Christmas period, they've got two league wins against Sheffield United and West Brom. Their points since beating Arsenal on December the 6th is relegation. And whilst people keep saying it will turn round, the reality is it's not going to stop anytime soon. I keep saying, but Jesus Christ in charge. Until they can actually do something about the playing personnel. And I think it's going to take a good few years. You're not going to get 15 players out of that club in the summer. And until they get bombed out because they're shit, it's plain and simple. So lay the back Spurs here, or back the draw and trade that when it shortens. You know, it's they're becoming a club. Oh, they should be better. They should be better. Look at the form the last 2 years. It's piss poor. It is dreadful. It is right up there at the bottom 16. Chelsea Man United, 2.34 Chelsea, 3.45 the draw, 3.45 United. Did I say that right? 2.34 Chelsea. This is an ultimate big six back the draw game for me. Those in ultimate, there's a video, you'll know what I'm talking about. And that's my play. Gun to my head, if I had to pick a winner, it would be Chelsea. I keep saying it, I like the squad. Lampard was a mistake. Tuchel will do well here if he's given any length of time. But it's a ripe qualifier for the back the draw. So that will be the play, as I say. But I think Chelsea might nick it. Sheffield United versus Liverpool, 8.2 Sheffield United, 5.4 the draw, 1.43 Liverpool. Liverpool obviously in a really bad spell. Absolute tragic news. Ree Allison, the goalkeeper yesterday, just horrible for the young man. And that puts football into perspective for sure. From a match point of view, I mean, it does all seem a bit incidental when you get news by like that, but from a match point of view, it's difficult to think the Blades can win this. Whatever's going on at Liverpool, you know, they've won three games all year, three straight defeats, lost four of the last five. So it's a question of, do you want to back Liverpool at 1.43? And given the current circumstances, personally, not in my life, I don't know. There'll be people obviously who do, but it's not for me. I'd expect Liverpool to win, but I couldn't get involved in this at 1.43, and I'd want double figures, the Blades. And as I said, I don't normally do the Monday night game, but I've got the Monday night game. It's Everton versus Saints, 2.24 Everton, 3.55 the draw, 3.6 the Saints. It's my bet of the weekend this week, and I mean, my eyes sort of, you know, in the cartoons when people's eyes went, the old character's eyes went out and stalks old Thomas, and the eyes shot out and back in again. I can't believe Everton's price here. I just can't believe it. 2.24. I mean, you always think you're missing something. I've got to back Everton. You know, 24 home games against middle third sides. They've won 14 of them. Southampton have lost 19 away to top half sides. Southampton lost 6 defeats in the last 7. 4 straight away defeats. You know, they're tumbling down the table. A great start, but they've been found out. Everton profitable at home, full stop, without anything. I'm just staggered. I am staggered. Everton's plus and odds are 1.86. I'm just absolutely staggered. It's a boots filling job on Everton, this, for me. It's a fill your boots. And again, another one, I think, over 2.5 goals. I expected it to be odds on. It's currently sitting at 2, so I think this is one to trade the 2.5. So, lump on, as they say. Lump on. Cautiously at your own peril. Lump on. Don't lump on. When I say lump on, what I mean, Andrew, is we have to act cautiously. We expect 3 goals, but it could be no goals. So we lump on, but we lump on with a cautious approach, and I'm cautiously optimistic that lumping on Andrew in such a nature will lead us to beat this thing and victory will be ours, or of course it may not. So cautiously lump on at your own peril. I don't know where that came from, just came into my head. Lump on, lump on. I think it's a great opportunity for the 2.5 to trade, and I just think that Everton are Sam Cassidy will be hiding behind his sofa going, why have I done this? But I think it's an absolute boot filler, Everton versus Saints. But at your own peril, at your own peril, lump on, don't lump on. And that's the lot. So obviously there's games in there. I like Leicester. I like the Everton game. I like the lay of Brighton. I do think Leeds will win, so there's stuff in there for you to play around, trade with, hopefully. I don't know whether you've enjoyed these or not, first year we've ever done these. They are sort of part of my plan for the podcast forward. But if there's anything else you'd like me to do, if you'd like me to do more European football, if you'd like me to relate it more to Poisson numbers, ELO, let me know. Again, the more feedback you give me, the better this thing becomes over a period of time. Have I got any other football for today? I may well have. Let me have a little look for you. A little Sporting Recife last night, eh? Beautiful. What have we got for you today? What have we got? There's not a massive amount, actually. I haven't got it's just not a great fixture list for me today. But we do have a first half goal at... I just need to check some odds. Bear with me, he says. Hang on, I need to move that screen over there. Do that. I need to get onto the old betting console and have a little look. Bear with me. Yeah, typical production issues. Basically called. Didn't have a bloody look before we kicked off. I've got to find the game now. Lovely, isn't it? Beautiful. And you love me talking you through all this. A first half goal at Jan Regensburg versus Paderborn. Jan Regensburg, Paderborn. So if it is 0-0, 25-30 minutes into the first half, drip lay for a first half goal. Drip lay the unders or back the overs, whatever is your fare. Have a beautiful little Friday. And this is going to be great when I do stop doing a couple of days. I'm not going to know what day of the week's going on here. And I'll be back with you all tomorrow morning. Fancy thinking the singing's going to stop, honestly. What's the matter with you? Right, I'm out of here. Have a lovely Friday, guys. Good luck with your bets this weekend. And I'll be back with you all tomorrow. Don't forget your breakfast. #FTS breakfast. It's going to be a decent prize.